So now we will start another technique, come under a atomic emission spectroscopy. So that is called plasma emission spectroscopy. So here plasma is used as a radiation source as well as a excitation source. Okay, for emission of a for measurement of a emitted radiation from a sample. First, we will know what is a plasma. So the best example is a sun. Okay, sun is an example of a plasma. So it is a made up of, generally that sun is made up of a fusion reaction of a hydrogen, and it form the helium, and it also consists of a ionized gas. Okay, so if we will tell the ionized gas, it consists of a like a hydrogen gas, hydrogen H plus and ions, and also the it also consists of a electrons. So similarly, here the plasma is a cloud of a highly ionized gas composed of ions, electrons, and a neutral particles. So this is a artificially made plasma. So that is used to atomize the element that project over the radiation source. So in plasma emission spectroscopy, the gas ionized by the influence of a strong electric field by direct current or a radio frequency. So in the sun, the fusion reaction, okay, causes the formation of plasma. But here the plasma is formed when the gas, so we will see what are the gas that can form the plasma under the influence of electric field. So the gas is passed over the strong electric field with a strong radio frequency wave, and that will form the plasma. So plasma can be formed by dispersing this gas over the high electric field. Okay, and the temperature of that plasma is 7000 to 1500 Kelvin. Okay, so the temperature of a plasma, and we know the temperature of the flame is about 2200 centigrade, and the temperature of this plasma is, I think, 5 to 6 times more, and that temperature will use to atomize and excite the element. So this is the instrumentation. Okay, so here we can see the instrumentation of a inductively coupled plasma, and it is a atomic emission spectroscopy. So that is also called atomic emission spectroscopy, or that AES is also called as a OES, optical emission spectroscopy. So this instrument consists of a plasma induced ICP, and then we have an analyzer, radio frequency generator, monochromator, and a detector. So here so here we will see how the plasma is formed, like a plasma of a sun. So here how the plasma means the temperature is around 15,000 Kelvin. So here that argon gas, okay, passed into the quartz tube containing that induction coil, okay, and also the high magnetic field. So when this gas is passed, then there around a 25 to 100 megahertz frequency of RA is passed over this induction coil, and this strong magnetic field and high radio frequency RF value causes the ionization of this inert gas. Okay, inert gas. And when this gas get ionized into this induction coil or a quartz tube, so it form the ionized gas like argon Ar plus and a number of 3 electron and neutral gases, okay, neutral gases of argon, and all together will cause the formation of plasma and causes the formation of plasma. So we can see the actual image of a plasma, okay, will looks like. So this is the formation of a plasma. So this is the plasma, and we have a radio frequency coil, and when the sample, so here only sample will sucked with the help of a nebulizer, okay, nebulizer, and when this sample reaches to the plasma, so it will volatilize, then it dried, it mines and excite. So here the atomization as well as excitation takes place with the help of this plasma. So then we have a monochromator. So the function of monochromator, as it is in the flame potentiometer, detector and signal processing. So here like this plasma, so in the sample so if you are analyzing any real sample, that may be a food origin or a clinical sample or a solid or a soil sample or a some ore samples, so that may containing several elements, okay, several elements. So as the temperature of that plasma is very high, so all the element will emit their particular wavelength, okay, several wavelength of light from the monochromator, okay, several wavelength of light, and that are relates with the different element present in the sample, and different wavelength of light emitted, and that is a we can say detected with several detector, okay, several. Suppose lambda 1 is a wavelength for calcium, lambda 2 is a wavelength for a like zinc, copper. So that they have different detectors. So at a time we can measure maybe more than 20 to 25 elements from the sample. So this is the presence of different detectors in ICP AES. So this is a brief about the ICP. So we can use 1 to 5 kilowatt, okay, and at the rate of 27 megahertz to 41 megahertz of a radio frequency, okay. Then so this is the formation of the plasma nebulizer. Then in nebulizer we have two types of nebulizer, pneumatic nebulizer and a fluid nebulizer. So in pneumatic nebulizer, where the capillary tube, okay, the sample solution is passed through the capillary tube, okay, and a fluid nebulizer, the sample solution pumped to a glass fluid membrane consisting of a porous coral like a synthetic material. So these are the formation of a process of nebulization through the different accessories that present into the instrument. So this is about the radio frequency, okay. So we will use that 5 to 100 megahertz, and that generally the radio frequency radiation is formed from the crystal, okay, some solid crystals. Then we have the monochromator. So the function of monochromator
scientists to select a particular wavelength of light, and the grating is used as a monochromator, and that monochromator can select wavelength of a 0.001 nanometer, difference in the emitted radiation. So this is a part of monochromator. Then detector, we can use a photomultiplier tube or charge coupled devices or a
photodiode arrays.
Because the photodiode arrays or a charge coupled devices are a multi-phase detector for a measurement of a several emitted radiation from the samples. So then we have another direct current plasma excitation.
Instead of a plasma,
we can use a direct current plasma excitation source.
But the most of the ICP containing a plasma type radiation source. So this is a periodic table. So
here we can see almost. So generally,
For atomic absorption spectroscopy, we can only analyze some selected element from the periodic table, because the atomization, the atomization of element is a very important issue. So some of the elements we cannot determine in a ICP but
these are the different elements that we can determine in a ICP MS.
So here instead of a AES,
here we will couple
mass spectrometer.
So here I think we can determine. So this light blue color, so we can determine 0.1 to 1 ppt parts per billion. Element from the sample, and this yellow color shows the 1 to 10 ppt. 10 and 10. So these are the different colors showing the sensitivity.
Sensitivity for the detection of element that present in a sample.
So these are different, we can say, sensitivity for the different technique. ICP-MS, ICP-OES. So here we can see ICP-MS is more sensitive than ICP-OES. And again, plain-AES is a less sensitive. Then this graphite furnace is more sensitive than plain-AES. And these techniques are more sensitive. And the use of this technique depends upon the amount of element that present into the sample.
Then finally, where this technique can be applied for determination of element.
So we can analyze the different elements like drinking water, effluent from industry, seawater analysis. We can test or toxic elements present in a food sample or a soil sample. And so these are a very toxic elements like lead, cadmium, mercury, arsenic,
and their analysis is a very important for a health issues.
And we can also analyze these elements in meat, pork, milk, tea, wine, and juice. So these are the applications of this ICP AES, and previously we have seen a flame photometry. Thank you.